Hi, everybody. Josh Byerly here inside Mission Control Houston. Most of you probably know the guy sitting beside me. This is Bill Foster. He's sort of a legend around these parts. He is a Mission Control Ground Controller, GC, as they call it here. That's the call sign. But what those guys do, there's an entire team that does it, but they basically run everything inside this building, all of our communication networks. They help us interface with the tracking and data relay satellite system. They've got a console back there at the back that looks like something out of the future. It's got lots of buttons on it. It's quite impressive, a little bit less than what we do over here. But Bill's here to talk about Mission Control and sort of some activity that's been taking place. You know, you guys have probably not seen the Space Shuttle Flight Control Room, which is down the hall from us here in the Space Station Room, in quite a long time. So, Bill, let's talk about, this is what it looks like now. We're taking a live shot of it. It looks quite a bit different than it did last time we saw it, doesn't it?
It is quite a bit different. It takes some getting used to. We started running some of our first testing out of there a couple of days ago. In fact, I think you've got a shot from that a little later. But
yeah.
The control center itself is in a big evolutionary process where we are moving from the current architecture, which everybody's familiar with yeah. the blue consoles.
Big blue consoles, yeah.
Into what we're calling MCC 21, a 21st century control center. Part of that is changing out the hardware, which is, like you can see, the brown, more clean type consoles, and that's something we're going to have to get used to because we don't have a lot of storage in there. You know, we've been trying for years to get away from a lot of paper media in front of
big
us.
Big binders. Matter of fact, you can't see them, but we've got right. tons of them over here. So.
And when we brought in the last version, the blue console back in the mid-90s, that was one of the big goals of that is pure electronic documentation.
Yeah.
Well, we're just not built that way. We don't think that way. And the monitors in front of us that we were planning on using for the documentation is what we use to look at data coming down from yeah. the spacecraft. And monitor real estate is pretty valuable. So we didn't want to take away what we needed to look at on board, or in my case, what's happening in the network or the equipment in the control center
right.
to look at procedures. So we never really got away from that. With the new control center, we're going to have even less space to store documents. So
many more monitors, though.
But many more monitors. Yeah. In fact, that's one of the things we're still struggling with is how to configure the monitors so that we can see the front screens and that the positions behind us see.
Yeah.
Even now at our console, we have a layout of monitors going horizontally, but there's one side of the console where stacked up to where if you're sitting on that side, you don't see the front of the room. So
yeah.
it's always a challenge, always working toward that.
Well, let's take a look at these pictures. I think we've got some photos of what
okay.
The room used to look like and kind of the build-out of it. So that's 135. That's July of 20. It's hard to believe that that's been more than 2 years ago, but that's
yep.
that's kind of the shot that everybody's familiar with. That's sort of the world-famous Mission Control shot that we've seen. And you, like you talked about, you see the blue consoles, and
right.
there's the surgeon console, and you guys are up there at the front.
It was a great room. It served its purpose for many years. We started flying shuttle out of there in 1995.
And we flew about half the shuttle missions, didn't we?
It was very close.
Yeah.
I'm not sure the exact division,
yeah.
but STS-70 was the first mission that was yeah. supported out of the White Vicar.
Yeah, so let's keep taking a look at these photos. We can put them up there and see what all happened as you guys started to tear out the equipment and things like that. I mean, because you basically had to come in there and basically strip the room bare, right?
Right, so here we're looking at it probably from last late winter time frame when the blue consoles were just about all out.
And what people don't realize, you see that, this is what's so funny the first time you walk in the room, you see those big squares in the floor. We actually have floating floors here in Mission Control. Look, they kind of give a little bit whenever you step in there, right?
Sorry about that. Clicked myself off. Hopefully they don't give too much. It's got a good base foundation, but we are walking about 28, 30 inches off of the
yeah.
actual floor.
There's lots of wires up under there. So let's keep going through the pictures and take a look at what was next.
Okay, now here we're bringing in the new equipment into the control room. So you're seeing the wooden consoles and
new paint job on the walls.
New paint job. They took all the plaques down and put them back up afterwards. And so we do like to keep a history of what was supported out of the room. The screens got wider.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's one thing I'm going to miss is in the White Vicar, we had room on either side of the screens for the flags to go up. So now they're going to go back on poles again, just like they are in this room.
Yeah.
But it was kind of nice for a while having the U.S. flag up on the wall with a light flooding it so it was visible to all.
So there's a look at it during the testing this week, right?
Right. So here we have all the displays up. Most of the displays you see right now are not functional yet. We're still starting to populate that with the new capabilities. On Tuesday, we ran for the first time with the the upgraded training system simulator, which we're calling Training Systems 21.
Yeah.
And that was very successful, able to command, able to get data in. So the developers that were in working that were very happy with the results and the progress that we're making. If things go as planned, then sometime in June or July of next year, 2014, the ISS support will move out of this room down the hall. The White Vicar, the shuttle control room. And for the next few months after that, this room will be upgraded.
And this will end up looking just like it.
It'll end up looking very much like it.
Yeah, we'll keep looking at these live shots of the room because, I mean, it's a different look. It's a different look. It has a different sort of feel to it, but it's more modern. And, you know, everybody knows that Orion will be run out of this room eventually. Let's talk about EFT-1 very quickly. EFT-1 is going to be run not actually out of that room. It's going to be run out of what we call the Blue Ficker, right?
It'll be out of the Blue Ficker. It's the original room that we flew station out
this
of.
One, yeah.
It's a smaller control room. It's also been upgraded to the MCC-21 configuration. In fact, I'm down there today. I stepped down the hall from that. We're running tests with the test rigs for Orion for the EFT-1 mission.
Yeah.
Currently, that's planned to launch in about a year from now, in September of 2014. Orion will eventually fly off of the Space Launch System, NASA's new rocket, heavy lifter. But for this first mission, it's going to go off of a Delta IV out of Cape Canaveral. We'll not have humans on board, but we'll do two orbits of the Earth, the second orbit going up to a high altitude of close to 4,000 miles.
It's way out there, yeah.
Yep. So that when it re-enters, it can re-enter close to the speed you would re-enter if you're coming back from the moon or any...
Way out there.
Way out
Mars
there.
Mars or an asteroid or something like that.
Exactly.
So, you know, we were talking before we came on the air about, and let's talk about the history of this place real quick before we wrap up. But, you know, people know Mission Control. They know that name. You know, it's in the movies and things like that. But the Mission Control Center is actually the whole building. This is what we call a flight control room. You'll hear us call it a Ficker. Of course, we love our acronyms around
here,
right?
Yes, we do.
So let's tell everybody, this is Ficker 1 that we're in right now. This is the space station room, and it used to be...
Moker 1.
Used to be Moker 1,
Mission Operations Control Room,
right?
Yep.
Actually, Apollo 7 was flown out of this room,
That's correct.
That we're sitting in now. Of course, it looked quite a bit different than it did back in the day. And then shuttle started in this room. Matter of fact, the patch is right above our head up here at STS-1.
First four shuttle missions out of this room.
Yeah, and then we ran some shuttle missions upstairs in what used to be Moker 2,
Moker
and
two.
Became Ficker 2.
For the last part of the... When I say the last part of the first half of the shuttle program, it became Ficker 2.
Yeah.
It's kind of funny because when the building opened up, these were Mokers, Mission Operations Control Rooms, and after the first four shuttle flights, the decision was made that we're no longer running missions, these are more flights,
mm-hmm.
which is why we changed the names to Ficker instead of Moker. And so from that time, these were Ficker 1, Ficker 2, We ran the first four shuttle flights out of this one, then we moved upstairs to Ficker 2 while we tore this room out and upgraded it to the shuttle era consoles back in the early 80s. Once this room was upgraded, we then started moving back and forth between the rooms because it was a big job to reconfigure since everything was running off mainframes.
Yeah.
All the buttons were individually wired to outputs of the mainframe.
Wow.
So it took literally months to reconfigure from one shuttle mission to the next. But later in the shuttle program, after the Challenger accident, the third floor was dedicated to Department of Defense missions.
Yeah.
And so we ran the last few Department of Defense missions out of the third floor, and when those were finished, it was shut down, and it had already been designated a National Historic
Landmark. That's the one you see in the movies, is the Apollo, or the famous Apollo room with the big green consoles and things like that. But in the mid-90s, we built the new section of Mission Control.
Yes.
And for some reason didn't call it Ficker 3 or Ficker 4. It became the White Ficker and the Blue Ficker. And there's a Red Ficker, too, but it's just a training room.
Right.
You know.
The Red Ficker is not going to be with us much longer.
No.
Once MCC-21 is complete, the training room on the third floor will be reutilized for other purposes, and we'll use the Blue Ficker for training.
Yeah. So you've got blue and white down there. The white one is the famous one that we just showed you a minute ago, the live shot that was the shuttle. I think it was just a coincidence, probably, that we call it white. And the shuttles were white. But that is going to be the Orion Flight Control Room, and these guys have been just working like crazy, trying to get that room back up and running and modernize. It is a change, like we talked about, but of course, this building has been migrating and morphing and changing.
The story of this building has changed
from
the original days through the mid-90s till now, and this won't be the last one. The evolution will continue as technology improves.
So our chairs may be a little bit different, but it's still an extremely cool cool feeling whenever you walk in there. So I think all of us probably still get chills whenever we walk in these rooms.
It's great walking in, particularly if you're coming in for a mission support. Yeah. I know in the shuttle days when I was coming in for a launch, you know, you just have a feeling, the whole hallways, everything feels different in the building when it's ready for mission.
Yeah. Well, Bill, thanks a lot for coming along. It's been cool to see this room and see it change. I'm glad it's almost ready to go.
So. It's exciting. A lot of things coming. Thanks, Josh.
Appreciate
it.
And thank you guys for joining us.